A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th April, on the front page you have BJP MLA, four security men killed in Dantewada Maoist attack. So this is regarding a Maoist attack in Dantewada district in Chhattisgarh. The extremists blew up a vehicle with explosives and opened fire at occupants. So BJP MLA and four security men were killed in this. Then on page 7 you have Centre's plea on excess land in Ayodhya case opposed. So this is the petition which the Supreme Court had filed. So this was that because the disputed area, you should know, in Ram Janmabhoomi case in Ayodhya is very less. The adjoining area has actually been acquired by the central government from various entities, so that the final verdict which is there on who gets hold on the Babri Masjid land, they should have sufficient land to have access to it too. So for that purpose, adjoining huge amount of adjoining area has been taken over. So you can see it's a total of 67.703 acres of land, including the disputed area is only 0.33 acres, so 0.313 acres. So this acquisition of land was centered in 1993 was to maintain communal harmony. So this now, what the center said in Supreme Court recently was that the government wants to give back this excess land to their respective owners. So this is actually when the case verdict is going to come up soon, and the purpose of the entire exercise would be served. But this is what center says, that they should get back the land which they are holding, and majority, a huge amount of this land belongs to the Hindu community. So here actually this center's plea has been opposed in the Supreme Court. Nimrohi Akhara, who is one of the main contenders in the Ayodhya title dispute appeals, objected to this plea in the Supreme Court to return superfluous land, and it said that this should not be gone ahead. So this land, leased land by the center state government, was to develop a Ram Katha Park. So Nimrohi Akhara says that one of the major landowners, Ram Janmabhoomi Nyas, to which center wants to release excess acquired Ayodhya land to establish on the basis, has been established on the basis of fraudulent deed. So its deed is a fraud. He was actually leased land to develop a Ram Katha Park. And Akhara says that excess land acquired under the Ayodhya Acquisition Act has several temples belonging to Nimrohi Akhara. So, release of these lands now by the government would frustrate the final outcome and the appeals pending in the Supreme Court. Then, below you have two held for assault on beef seller. So, this is an incident which has now happened in Assam. So, selling meat of any kind was never an issue. But now you can see that a man was assaulted by a mob for allegedly selling beef. So, police in Assam have identified the accused from the video of assault which was uploaded on social media. And here you have, Center denies RTI plea on CIC appointments. So, the central government has denied RTI request for details of the ongoing recruitment process for four vacancies in the Central Information Commission. So, recent Supreme Court order has mandated that such information should be made public, but the Center has denied any such details. Then on editorial page, the first editorial is Blinkers On. So this is regarding BJP manifesto, Sankalp Patra, which was released. So the editorial says the BJP's manifesto is unabashed about its narrowly nationalist agenda. And the second editorial, Closure on Cynicism. So this is regarding Supreme Court solution to increase VVPAT verification up to 5, as such, per assembly constituency. So, this should reassure the EVM skeptics, is what the editorial says. Then the lead article is Technology and the Unhurried Mind. So, this is regarding EVMs. So, here it says the saga of the EVMs has started looking tedious to many people. Abundant caution would help. Regarding the EVMs and the controversy surrounding it. And this is Brexit and the fragility of the UK. So UK has become fragile. The muddle over how to leave the EU is threatening UK's sway over London's sway over Scotland and Northern Ireland. Then on op-ed page we have using artifacts to tell stories. So this is regarding how India's ossified art museums can reorganize their galleries. And this is there a problem with the 10% quota? So this says that data shows that economically weaker sections in the general category are already well represented in higher education. So this is a critique on 10% quota actually. On international page you have Sri Lanka opens China finance railway line. So this extension is the first to be constructed in the country since independence. So this is a railway line connecting the coastal city of Matara and Belatta in Hambantota. So it is expected to boost passenger traffic in the island nation's south region too. Then below you have IMF forecasts dip in global growth in 2019. So India's growth is projected to pick up from 7.1% last year to 7.3% in 2019 and 7.5% in 2020. So this is International Monetary Fund forecast. Global growth forecast is of 3.3% in 2019, down from 3.6% in 2018. So global growth is taking a dip, but Indian growth projection is upwards. And this is no apology for Jallianwala Bagh for now, says UK. So Jallianwala Bagh incident is important because it is 100th year of the incident in 2018-19 now. So Minister for Asia and Pacific in UK, Mark Field, has said the issue of apology for Jallianwala Bagh is a work in progress. And he says no apology for now. So this is an important issue, you should know about it. On business page you have major banks begin to slash lending rates, EMIs set to drop. So State Bank of India, Indian Overseas Bank all have cut their MCLR linked lending rates by 5 basis points too. So this is regarding how banks are reducing or bringing down their lending rates. And this is India's gold reserves increase marginally in February. So this is World Gold Council, which has said that India's gold reserves have seen a marginal increase. Globally, gold reserves with central banks rose by 51 tons, the highest since October 2018. The top 10 countries in gold reserves are shown here. It is said apart from India, only Russia and China increased their holdings in February 2019. Then on page 14 you have ArcelorMittal may have to deposit bid amount of 42,000 crores rupees. So this is National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, which has asked ArcelorMittal to file an affidavit on steps it has taken to execute SR Steel Resolution Plan, which it has been awarded. Then this is ease norms for e-bike subsidies, says electric vehicle makers. So Society for Manufacturers of Electric Vehicles have urged the Project Implementation and Sanction Committee to delink localization and ex-showroom prices of e-bikes from subsidy under the FAME II scheme, that is faster adoption and manufacturing of e-vehicles, even hybrid vehicles included. So this is it is asking that for e-bike subsidy the norms should be eased. And on the last page there is no news. This is actually about how print news is the newspapers have come together and saying that if we don't have facts, we don't print the news. For social media, they say it is sensation, and if the story doesn't check out, it can always be deleted from social media. But newspapers have no such luxury. Millions have a copy of it in their hands. So before printing a news, they verify all information, and news here is backed by facts. Print is proof. So these are leading newspapers coming together and issuing this. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com and access the PDF file too. Plus also the detailed current affairs video is a separate course for which you can enroll. Thank you.